drainage density. Now, if you have a look at drainage density, people, and immediately this diagram, we've got here a high drainage density. Look at all the rivers here, right, where the tributaries. So we've got a high drainage drainage density there, and just compare to this one here at the bottom. Immediately you see there's a huge difference between the two here. But now the question is, why? Why have we got a high drainage density there, and why do we have a low drainage density here? People, you must be able to answer that question in the exams. Please, let us have a look at that. Okay, now if we have a look at this, we will see that this area here, this area, the lighter shaded area here, this area has a higher rainfall. Of course, higher rainfall. That's why we've got more rivers there. Hard rocks. Now, why hard rocks? Got hard rocks so the water can't drain through and the water actually remains on the surface of the earth. Steep slopes, less vegetation, and I've already mentioned less infiltration. So that is why we have a high drainage density in that area. If we look at the one below here, of course, people, just have a look at the two. You know, you only need to study the one, because the other one is just exactly the opposite. Have a look at this. The high density, there's my reasons. Low density, here's my reasons. Exactly the opposite. Look at that. High rainfall, of course, lower rainfall, because you have far less streams. Hard rocks, soft rocks. Steep slopes, gentle slopes. Less vegetation, lots of vegetation. Less infiltration, more infiltration. So people, this is very, very easy. Okay, so see that you are in the position that you can identify your high drainage density and a low drainage density, and of course give reasons why do we have a high density drainage density in certain area, and at another area a lower drainage density.